Bonjour, je m'appelle Dr. Tim et bienvenue à French 2311, chapitre 8, leçon 3. Aujourd'hui, nous allons étudier quelques verbes irréguliers en IR. Quelques verbes irréguliers en IR. Ça va? J'espère que vous allez très bien. Hello, my name is Dr. Tin and welcome to French 2311, Chapter 8, Lesson 3. Today we are going to study some irregular IR verbs. Irregular IR verbs. You will find IR at the end of these verbs. We've done some regular ones, right? Like finir, agir, choisir. Now we are going to study some IR verbs that fall into a second group. Right, and these verbs are irregular. They won't follow the rules of the first IR verbs like choisir and finir. Ça va? Okay, allez-y. Okay, page 206, 208. 206, 208. Quelques verbes irréguliers en IR. Quelques verbes irréguliers en IR. So you'll find IR at the end of these verbs, just like finir, choisir, agir, right? Réfléchir. But these verbs are conjugated differently from the first set of IR verbs. Okay. Dormir. Dormir. To do dormir, partir or sortir. These three will go together and later on we will do venir, which is different. Okay. Dormir. To sleep. Partir. To leave or to depart. Sortir, to leave also, or to go out. Ça va? Très bien. Dormir, partir, sortir. Okay. Partir is the opposite of arriver. Arriver. To arrive, right? The opposite of to arrive is to depart. To depart. So, partir will have the sense of departing on a journey, right? Okay. It also means to leave. To leave. Okay. It will have a preposition after it. The preposition from or the preposition for, right? I'm leaving from Paris and I'm leaving for New York, right? Pour, for, de. Okay? It will always have a preposition if you're using a place after it, right? It can stand alone. Je pars, I'm leaving. But when you are being specific, right? I'm leaving for New York, right? It will have parti. When parti is used, you will have a preposition after parti. I'm leaving from Paris. Then you use a preposition de, right? After parti. I'm leaving for New York, then you use the preposition pour after partie. Ça va? Now the verb sortie is the opposite of entrer, to enter, right? So this means to go out. It can mean also to go out to have fun, right? I'm going out with my friends, right? Or it can simply mean to leave. But here, it will mean not to leave on a long journey. Just like you're leaving the pool because it's very cold, you will use sortir and not partir, right? If you're leaving from a classroom, all right, you can say je pars de la salle de classe or je sors de la salle de classe, right? They will mean the same thing. Ça va? And sortir, when it has the sense of leaving from, right? You will use the preposition de after it. Ça va? Très bien. Let's go to the conjugation in the present tense. Okay, here, dormir, to sleep, right? To sleep. Partir, to leave. Sortir, to leave also. This has the sense of departing. This has the sense of just leaving a room and then hanging with your friends, having fun with your friends. You're going to the movie, you will say, je sors au cinéma. Je sors au cinéma. Okay? Très bien. So, dormir. For je, tu, il, elle, on. Okay? You will drop the last three letters. Right? So here we have dormir. M-I-R will be dropped. Parti, T-I-R will be dropped. Sortir, T-I-R will be dropped. For je, tu, il, elle, on. You will drop the last three letters of the infinitive of dormir, partir, sortir. For je, you will add S. Je dors, je pars, je sors. For tu, you add also S. Tu dors, tu pars, tu sors. For il, elle, on. You add T. Okay. Il, elle, on dort. Il est en part. Avec T. Il, elle, on sort avec T. So, dor, T ici, par, T. Sort, so S-S-T. Ça va? Ok, for, je, tu, il, elle, on, right? S-S-T, right? You will drop the last three letters of the infinitive of dormir, partir, sortir, to do the present tense of je, tu, il, elle, on. For the plural pronoun, for the subject pronouns that are plural, you will just drop the IR. Okay, for nous, for vous, and for il, elle, pluriel, you will drop IR. Okay, so you are here, you're left with dom. Here you are left with pact. Here you are left with sot. And then you go ahead and add the normal endings that you will normally add to your ER verbs, O-N-S-E-Z-E-N-T, right? So, nous dormons, vous dormez, il, elle dorment. The ENT, as we said, is always silent when it's a conjugation of a verb. Ça va? So, nous dormons, que nous dormons, vous dormez, il, elle dorment. Okay, for party, you just drop the IR. For nous, vous, il, elle. So you will add the ONS here. So nous partons, vous partez, the EZ, right? It's always pronounced A. Vous partez, il, elle partent. For sortons, right? For nous, vous, il, elle, you've dropped the IR. Okay, so nous sortons, vous sortez, il, elle sortent. Okay, sortant, sortez, il, elle, sort. Okay, now, here, how do you use parti? How do you use sorti? First of all, they all mean to leave, L-E-A-V-E, right? To leave a place, right? To leave a place. Here, parti has the sense of the opposite of arriver. To arrive, the opposite is to depart, right? So, it will use the preposition de to depart from or to leave from a place and to leave for. When it's to leave from, it will use the preposition de. When it's to leave for, it will use the preposition pour. Okay? So here, je pars de Paris. I'm leaving Paris. The verb partir will use the preposition de. I'm leaving from Paris, right? I'm leaving Paris. I'm departing from, okay? I'm departing from Paris. And then I'm leaving for New York will be parti pour. And then here, il parle pour New York. He's leaving for New York. Okay, now another verb, the verb quitter, can take the place of this very sentence. Je pars de Paris. But when the verb quitter, répéter, quitter is used, it means to leave, right? And it's directly followed by the town or the person you are leaving. It can be a person or a town, right? It can be your job you're leaving. It can be you're leaving Paris. So here, I'm departing, right, from Paris, right? I'm leaving Paris. Here, I'm leaving. The verb quitter is used, and you see that it has not been used with a preposition. Just the town will come directly after quitter. So, je quitte Paris is the same thing as je pars de Paris. right? I'm leaving Paris. But when you use the verb quitter, you don't use a preposition. Ça va? Très bien. Okay? The verb sortir will also use the preposition de when you are leaving a place, right? You're leaving a place. So, je sors de la salle de classe. I'm leaving the class, right? Je sors de la salle de classe. I'm leaving the classroom, okay? You can also use quitter there. Je quitte la salle de classe, right? Je sors de la salle de classe. Je quitte la salle de classe. Okay, so de with sortir, the same thing with party. Now, sortir can also mean you're having fun with friends. You go out, you're hanging with friends, right? You are going out with somebody on a regular basis, like a boyfriend, girlfriend. You can use sortir alone. Nous sortons ensemble. We're going out together. Nous sortons ensemble. Nous sortons. Okay? Nous sortons ensemble. We are going out together. To go out, to have fun. Okay. So, you can say, je sors avec mes amis ce soir. You're going out to have fun with your friends this evening. Right? It doesn't have the sense of just leaving physically home. It just has the sense of you going out, right? Having fun with your friends. Although you leave the house, but it has the sense of hanging, right? I'm going out with my friends. So, je sors avec mes amis ce soir. I'm going out with my friends this evening. Okay, if you are physically leaving a place, all right, then you will need the preposition de after sortir. Okay, for instance, nous sortons de la piscine. We are leaving the pool because maybe it is so cold you can no longer swim. So, nous sortons de la piscine. When you leave out do here, it will not make any sense. It's incorrect in French. So, nous sortons de la piscine. Ça va? Très bien. Now, let's do the verb venir. 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 Venir means to come. Alright? So, you see that it's different from dormir, parti, sorti. Okay, here, you have to learn venir on its own terms. Je viens, I come. Tu viens. See the SST, but it does not follow this rule, right? Okay, je viens, tu viens, il, elle, on vient. Nous venons, right? Vous venez, and then ils, elles viennent. Learn the verb venir on its own terms. Don't follow the rules of dormir, sortir, and partir. Learn venir on its own terms. Je viens, tu viens, il, elle, on vient. Nous venons, vous venez, ils, elles viennent. Okay, there's a structure, grammatical structure with the verb venir. Venir de. Okay. When you have done something in the most recent past, right? You will use the expression, the verb venir de followed by an infinitive. Okay? Venir de, and then l'infinitif. Infinitif. To express a very recent action, right? So let's say you just ate. You just ate. You will say, je, je viens, je viens de, and then the infinitive of the verb to eat will follow. Je viens de manger. Je viens de manger. I just ate. I just ate. Okay. Now, il vient de sortir. Il vient de sortir. See, sortir is used in its infinitive, right? The verb is not conjugated, right? So here, it means he just left. He just left. It is called le passé récent. The recent past, right? Le passé récent. So to express a recent action in the past, you will use the expression venir de followed by an infinitive form of the action. Je viens de parler. I just spoke to my professor. Je viens de parler à mon professeur. Je viens d'étudier le français. I just studied French. Ça va? Au revoir et à bientôt.